In trading, the past is just the prologue. The real story is the future. So how do we look forward? We venture into the volatile world of options. Each options price holds a clue, a glimpse of the market's own forecast of risk ahead. And when we piece those clues together, we get a 3D map of the market's expectations, known as the volatility surface. We can look at a stock's historical returns, put them in a histogram, and see that familiar bell curve. From that curve, we can calculate the standard deviation, and that gives us a single number for realized volatility. That tells us how much the stock has bounced around in the past. But what if we want to know what the market thinks will happen tomorrow? That brings us to implied volatility. Think of it like this. A meteorologist can describe yesterday's weather with perfect accuracy, but their real value is in forecasting tomorrow's storm. The same is true for volatility. Realized volatility is yesterday's weather. Implied volatility is the market's forecast. Implied volatility is unobservable, but it's what we really need to know. The key insight is making the connection between option pricing and volatility. When quants price an option, they feed a model with a set of inputs. The current stock price, the strike price, the time to expiration, the risk-free interest rate, and the volatility. The first four are straightforward. You can look them up. Volatility is different. It is, once again, the missing piece. It cannot be observed directly. And because it must be estimated, it's the source of disagreement. It can also be the source of opportunity. So how do we get at this unobservable variable? The answer is to turn the problem on its head. For European options, quants have a well-established formula for estimating price. It's the Black-Scholes equation. It takes in all those observable inputs, the stock price, the strike, the time to expiration, and the risk-free rate. It also needs an estimate for volatility. Out comes a theoretical option price, but what if we reverse the process? The market is constantly providing us with a price for every option. We can simply take that price and plug it back into the Black-Scholes formula. We then numerically solve for the volatility that gives us that exact market price. We call the result the implied volatility. It's the volatility the market is implying by the price it has set. What about American options? Their prices cannot be calculated with the Black-Scholes formula because of one key difference from European options. American options can be exercised at any time before expiration. That flexibility makes them more valuable and more complex to price. To handle this, quants turn to other methods, for example, binomial trees, finite difference schemes, or Monte Carlo simulations. For our purposes, the details of each model matter less than the principle they share. Just like with European options, we take the market price of the American option and back solve for the volatility. Here's our American options pricing machine. It accepts the same inputs as the Black-Scholes equation and spits out the price. We can reverse this process by inserting the market price for the stock option. We then solve to find what the corresponding volatility needs to be. This value is the implied volatility. Do you feel yourself becoming stronger, faster, more powerful? That's the effect Socratica has on a lot of people. Would you like to learn more? If so, join our tastefully infrequent mailing list. We only say something when we have something to say. You can find the implied volatility for options on some financial sites. Typically, you'll see the data for all of the options grouped by expiration date. This table is called an option chain. Pick a stock. You'll notice that the implied volatility isn't the same for every option. Instead, you'll see a whole range of implied volatilities, depending on the strike price and expiration date. Is this surprising? Why isn't there just one implied volatility for the stock? Turns out, the market's perception of risk changes depending on the scenario. Different strikes, different expirations, different expectations. To understand these differences, we create a plot of all the implied volatilities. The result is a 3D visualization we call the volatility surface. Think of the surface as a heat map of how the market perceives risk across all these different conditions. Once we have this surface, we can identify which parts look normal and which parts look unusual. When we plot implied volatilities against both strike price and expiration, we don't see a flat sheet. Instead, shapes begin to emerge. Across strike prices, implied volatility often curves upward. Options far out of the money tend to have higher implied volatilities than those near the money. A common reason is that traders are willing to pay more for protection against possible catastrophic moves. This pattern is called the volatility smile. In equity markets, it often tilts to one side, creating more of a skew or a smirk. Now for the time dimension. Across expirations, implied volatility also changes. For example, implied volatilities might be a bit higher for options expiring right around a major event and then settle down afterward. Short-dated options might have low implied volatility, while longer-dated options can be higher. The behavior over time is called the term structure of volatility. So the volatility surface shows us two things at once: how the market prices risk at different strikes, and how it prices risk over different time horizons. Let's return to the most striking feature of the volatility surface, the smile. The key idea is that implied volatility isn't uniform across all strike prices. Instead of a flat line, we see a curve, a smile, or a smirk, because the market's perception of risk changes depending on the strike. Why does it curve? Trader opinion and demand. Far out of the money options, whether calls or puts, serve almost like insurance policies for unlikely but extreme events. The general principle is the further you move from the at-the-money strike, the more the market charges for that insurance. Hence, implied volatility rises. But it's not just about insurance. Speculators play a role too, adding a bit of extra demand for options that could pay off big if a rare event occurs. Altogether, that's why the surface curves upward into a smile or a smirk instead of staying flat. It's the market's way of pricing in both fear and speculation. We'll now explore in more detail how implied volatility varies over time. We'll often see the volatility surface rise as it gets further away from the present. Just like a term structure in bonds or interest rates, it's a way of noting how market expectations evolve over time. So what's the general principle here? Near-term options, those expiring soon, often show different implied volatilities than options that expire further out. Longer-dated options often have higher implied volatility because there's more time for big events like earnings announcements or economic changes to unfold. But not always, as we see here. And it's not always just a smooth slope. Sometimes, around known future events, you'll see bumps or dips in the surface. If everyone's anticipating a major announcement, the implied volatility for options expiring just after that date might spike. In other words, the volatility term structure is a timeline of the market's evolving expectations. We're not just looking at a single point in time, we're seeing how the market's view of risk stretches out into the future. We've seen how the volatility surface is a dynamic, real-time map of the market's expectations. So how do quants use it? First, the surface allows us to spot potential mispricing. If there's a bump in the volatility surface, something that looks out of place, that might indicate an arbitrage opportunity. If an option's implied volatility falls below the surface, it might be undervalued. If it's too high, it might be overvalued. Second, while quants do rely on the Greeks, like Vega, for day-to-day risk management, the volatility surface provides a global view of the risk landscape. It's a topographical map of how volatility changes across different strikes and expirations. That broader view helps quants understand how their portfolio might be affected by changes in volatility over time. And significantly, if you can predict the surface, this gives you an edge. If you have a different view of future volatility than what the market's implying, you can structure trades around that view. Essentially, you're using the volatility surface to find and act on opportunities that others might not see. Implied volatility is about reading between the lines, uncovering what the market believes, even when it cannot be seen directly. If you've enjoyed learning how to extract those hidden signals, you'll find more to explore in our finance courses. Perfect for aspiring quants. At Socratica, we teach everything with the same spirit of inquiry you've seen here.